everybody. It is I, Mara Vitus, from 3DX Chat with another how-to tutorial for us builders. All right, so the first thing I want to say is a big shout out goes to St. Vitus for this, because he is the one that not only taught me how to build, but he is the one that taught me about the little trick that I'm about to tell you guys about. And let me tell you, this is going to save you hours of time. The little trick I'm going to show you, I call it the V-snap. And I call it the V-snap because when you're doing it, you have to hold down the letter V on your keyboard. So first, to start off, we're going to go into walk around mode, because I don't know if you guys know this, but in build mode, yes, you can physically move around. Yes, you're only able to run, but you can still do it. You unfortunately cannot use the poses while you're in build mode. I am trying to get that done. I'm trying to get more forum posts in the 3DX chat forums to get Gizmo and them to add that option for us builders, because let me tell you, it would definitely save us a lot of time, especially when it comes to stool poses. But we're going to go back into non-moving mode, and I'm going to start off by showing you how to do this with a very basic shape. The square. The box. It's very easy to do. So the first thing you want to do is this. Now that I'm out of build mode, or now that I'm in build mode, I'm going to change a couple of things here just to make my life a little bit easier. See the size of the gizmo? I'm going to go make that a little bit bigger. So we're going to go into settings in the upper right-hand corner, and then we're going to go down to gizmo scale, and I'm going to change it from a size 1 to a size 3. Now it's going to make it a little bit easier for me to see and to grab and move around stuff. So before, when I was doing this, I was sitting here doing things like sliding it bit by bit. I'm like, okay, is it close enough? Oh, I don't know. Let's try this. And then I was doing this. I mean, let me tell you, it's very freaking tedious. And then you'd pull back and then you'd like have to do this and zoom in and, you know, bring your camera out and zoom in. Then you're like, oh crap, I can see a line. Then you're like, oh God. So let's not do that. The easiest thing to do when it comes to snapping pieces together, if you want them to line up, is to V-snap it. And this is what you do. So I want to snap this corner here, because you've got 8 corners here. You got 4 on the top, 4 on the bottom. And you can take a look, see, you can even use this corner in the that you physically can't see that's on the other side, but we're not going to do that. I'm not going to make it complicated for you guys. So I want to snap this corner here to this guy right here. Right? So what you do is you hold the V key down. Well, actually, first of all, at the top right or top center, you got to make sure you're on center, not pivot. That's going to make your life a little bit easier as well. So you're going to go on to be making sure you're on center, and you're going to make sure you're on the move gizmo. So we're going to move this corner here. Hold down the V key. See what happened to my gizmo? When you hold down the letter V, your gizmo moves to whatever point you're closest to, and it changes the center of the gizmo to a white square. So go into there, into the white square, left click and hold down your left mouse button and then move it. Don't panic if it disappears. It's just moving to a different part of the map. See? It's still there. It's just underneath my floor. And once you get to the point that you want to be at, let go. That's exactly how it's done. And it is done. Like, it's snapped perfectly into place. So now I'm going to show it to you again. I'm going to copy the square. I'm going to move it out. Except this time I'm going to move this point here to this top point here. I could go to the bottom one, but then I'd be burying it underneath the floor. I don't want to do that. So I'm going to take this point here and put it on this top point here. So hold down the letter V. It's going to change. And I can use any point I want. I can even move this point. Heck, I can move it to this point here. See? Boom, 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 boom. I just don't want to do that. That's not what I want to do. I want to move this point here to this point here. So we're going to hold down the V key and we're going to move it to this point here. Once you're lined up, let go of your buttons and you're good. See? Now, have you ever walked into a room and seen a perfectly organized and lined up checkerboard type of floor? Like checkered floor, and you're sitting here going, that's really detailed. This is how they do it. This is exactly how they do it. So what we're going to do now is we're going to hold the control key down and select all 3 pieces. We're going to copy them, and I'm now going to snap this corner here to this one here. So hold the V key down, and I'm going to snap it into place. See what's happening here? This is exactly how they do their floors. So, we're going to select the pieces, and now I'm going to group them together. And now I'm going to snap. I don't know. Let's see here. I'm going to snap this corner here to this one. I can't really see it. Hold on, because my gizmo's in the way. I'm going to snap this corner here to this corner here. Watch. So hold down the V key. And I'm going to snap. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? I forgot to copy my pieces. So copy it. Hold down the V key. And then I'm going to snap it into place. See? And now I'm going to copy it again. And where am I going to go with this? I'm going to go, you know what? I'm going to snap this corner here to this piece right here. Oh, let's not do that. Let's do it here. There we go. And you're like, wow, that's actually kind of handy. It's very handy. Let me tell you guys, this is a huge lifesaver. It saves so much time. You have no idea. And then I've copied it, so I want to hold down this key, and I'm going to snap it to this one. See, it's slowly becoming a checker. Now, I'm going to group all of this together. Okay. I'm going to group it all together. And I'm going to copy it. And I'm going to snap this corner to this one. Watch this. You're probably like, what did she just do? Now, you're probably wondering why I just did that. Well, what happens when I change the color? I now have a black and white checkered floor. Ta-da! There you go. That's how people do it. So that's how you create your checkered floor. Now, some people are like, hey, does it work with other shapes? Yes. I'm going to show you something. I don't know if you guys picked up on this when you're building. Every shape that you click on has a box around it. And that's basically the box that you're working with. When you click on an item, see, it's got a perfect... It doesn't matter what the shape is. It's got that box. I call it... It's called a hitbox. See? Even these rounded edged squares have these hitboxes around them. And they're perfect squares every time. So we're going to snap these two pieces together. I'm just going to kind of move it around. Watch this. I'm going to snap this together. Now, with this one, it's a little bit different. Because it all depends on what kind of look you want. Because it's going to have different points that you can kind of sync it up with. Because of the fact that it's got a rounded edge. But it still syncs up and it still lines up perfectly. See? I actually built a chair out of these boxes using this V-snap. Let me tell you, it was really handy. And then you can copy that piece, move it out, and then we can move it and we can snap it to here. Let's actually move that up a bit because it didn't snap quite to the top where I wanted. There we go. There we go. See? That's where I wanted it. Perfect. And then let's see if we can get a smoother line on this one. There we go. See? And then what you can do is you can copy this and you can now snap this piece. There you go. So it's a little bit different with the rounded ones, but it still works and it still looks really schnazzy. Like you can build a sofa with this. This is just doing a checkerboard pattern, but that's how it works. Now I'm going to show you how this works with these two shapes here. The cone and the cylinder. So as you can see, it's got the box on it. This is pretty simple to do because the cone has a perfectly round and flat bottom. You can just slip it right on top of here. So what you do again is you hold the V key down and just pick whatever point and then start moving it until it's lined up. There you go. And it's done. No tedious zooming in and lining it step by step by step. It's literally just completed and done. I will actually show you for those of you. You know what? This is going to be really handy. I'm going to show you guys something. Let's go to objects. I'm going to call up a cylinder and I'm going to call up another shape. This one here. Now, you guys are probably wondering, what is this for? Okay. Ever tried to make a champagne bottle? I have. Let's try this. I'm going to show you guys something. I'm actually... Let's do this. All right. So now let's go back to move. Click on the letter V. Boom. There we go. And then all you need to do is create another cylinder, shrink it down to size, and put it on top of here. And you're good. This is the beginning of a champagne bottle. Then you go to materials, go to patterns, or no, sorry, not patterns, solid colors, and go to bottled glass, and that is the beginning of your champagne bottle. Ta-da! See? It's super simple. It is the easiest. This V-snap is like one of the handiest tools and tricks you will ever have. Does it work for the ropes? Yep, it certainly does. Let's try this. So, as again, you see the hitbox is this green outline box around the shape. Same with this one. So we're going to tap on this, hold down the V key, go down to the edge, and we're going to move it till it snaps into place, and you're done. Ta-da! So, stairs. I'm gonna show you these ones last. No, actually, I'll show you these now. Let's do that. So let's do this. Now, to get these to work, I gotta turn them because I wanna make a winding staircase. So I'm gonna show you guys this. So let's get these turned around. And then we're gonna move. Okay, so there's a trick to these. I'm gonna show you guys this. To get this to work, okay, let me just raise this up a bit. You need to snap. There's two points that you gotta work with here. You need to snap this bottom corner to this bottom corner here, right there, okay? So you're gonna hold the V key down, pick this point and snap it to this one here and let go. Do you see how perfect that lined up? And then you can change it to whatever material you want. So say you want, I don't know, marble. Let's go to marble, solid colors. What do we got here? Well, let's go to, I don't know, let's go to bricks and blocks. Let's try this one. There we go, that's a fancy schmancy. Nah, let's go this way. Oh, that doesn't look nice. I don't like, well, yeah, actually it does, like granite. There we go. Now, you're wondering if it works. Am I gonna get stuck on them at all? Nope, watch. I'm gonna show you that I won't. So we're gonna go into regular mode and I'm gonna actually walk up these stairs because the biggest thing is that people keep getting stuck. And it's so frustrating when I'm in a room and I'm going up somebody's stairs and I get stuck and I'm like, ugh. Because I hate to say it, guys, being a builder, builders tend to be really picky about certain things. See, I didn't get stuck at all. Nada. And it looks nice. And it's one smooth motion. Now, you're all wondering, but what about the other stairs? Other stairs, you say? What other stairs? Oh, okay, so I'm going to go back into build mode. I'm going to show you the other stairs. These were the epitome of my stress when it came to building in this freaking game. So I'm going to call up the other stairs. These guys first. Okay. Now these guys first. So these guys here are the standard stairs that we use. And as you can see, they have some weird funky bottom thing. I don't know why they do this. And on the other side too. I have no clue why they designed that way. Beats the heck out of me. So why did they do anything in here? Okay. So as you know, when you're using the V-snap, you have to snap it from one corner to another corner. So you're like, but what if I want it in the center of the floor? Well, I'll show you. So we're going to snap this to this corner over here. We have to pick another corner. There's no ifs, ands, or buts around it. That's why I call it V-snap, because you're snapping it to another vertex or another point, another angle. Okay. So what we want to do is we want to snap. Sorry, I'm really sick right now, so I apologize. What we want to do is we want to snap. Let me see if I can bring this a little bit closer, actually. So we want to snap this guy here, not this one, this guy to this corner. So what you're going to do is you're going to hold down your V key. See how it's at that point? You could pick whatever point, whatever vertex you want. This one, whatever one. Whatever you want to snap into place, as long as you pick the right point and you to snap it to, you're good. So you're going to hold down the V key and you are going to click on it and snap it to place. There, done. See? Perfect. See? Nope, sorry. Keeps fitting can be okay. So now you're like, well, what if I want it like in the middle of the room? Just move it, slide it over, because that's the good handy thing about this gizmo, the moving gizmo. You can move it left and right and it'll stay lined up with the floor. It's only if you move it back and forth and up and down that you'll unsync it again. You'll have to do the V-snap again to line it up perfectly. So say you want to widen it. Well, just do that. Oop, nope, that's not what I want to do. Make it wider. There you go. Okay, so then you're like, but what if, are you going to get stuck at the top? Okay, so to test this out, I'm going to copy the floor. And now I'm going to snap it. This is a big move. So I'm going to actually take this and cut this down to size. Some of my favorite music playing in the background here. So I'm going to snap. Let's try this. I'm going to take this. I'm going to make this just a little bit smaller. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. There we go. Okay. See how I still have the outline? Okay. So I'm going to change this to that. I'm going to snap it over here. It might take me a couple of like shifts, but I'll show you how I'm going to do it. Hold the V key down. Now, I don't want the bottom one. I want the top one because I want to line it up at the top of the stairs. Correct? Correct. Okay. Let's see how I did. Did I do it? Holy shenanigans. I pretty much did. Okay. So hold that and I'm going to actually bring it back to here. Now it's not clipping. See that? Perfect. So now I'm just going to like bring that over and it's now perfectly lined up top and bottom. And you're sitting here going, what? Okay, so now I'm going to go back into regular world mode. And I'll show you guys. Nope, I'm not going to get stuck at the top of it. So I'm going to run over there first. Now, some people are like, but if I run, I won't get stuck. Oh, I beg to differ. So I'm going to show you walking up the stairs. I will not get stuck on this no matter what angle I go across. See? Perfectly lined up V-snapped stairs. Again, St. Vitus, thank you so much for showing me this. It has saved me a huge amount of time in build mode. Mountains and mountains of time. No issues coming up or down. Nope, not at all. Done and done. I'm going to show you one last thing. Actually, you know what? That's pretty much it. That is the last one I wanted to show you was these stairs. Okay, so that concludes my second tutorial, the V-snap. I hope you guys have an awesome night. I hope you guys have an awesome night. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch my new tutorial. If you guys have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them in the comment section below, and I will get to them as soon as I possibly can. I hope you guys have a great night. I will see you all in game, and happy building.